those who don't know who you are, who live under a rock, why don't you tell everyone who you are?
I'm Chris from Motionless In White.
What do you do in the band?
I sing.
All right. So you got done this year. You guys played Bamboozle for the second time in a few dates at Warped. How was that?
Awesome. Warped Tour is the best tour you could ever be on. Aside from the fact that it's hot as fuck, it's definitely so worth it to like get on that tour. And this tour has been really cool too. So.
So, you guys pretty much just released your Creatures video, you know, making teasers and stuff for it. How do you personally feel about the video?
I mean, our initial intention with the video was to just do something that, you know, in a very graphic or, you know, shocking way, grab the attention of people to get the better message across, which a lot of people don't understand what the song is about. And I guess for the record, it's about, you know, the general theme of it is pretty much, you know, what exactly the song is about. There's more inside us, more inside somebody than what you see on the outside, which is why we use, you know, typical characters like, showing his ass to us. We use like typical characters like, you know, a little girl, a businessman, and a priest. You know, three people that generally other people look at as normal and, you know, wouldn't have that kind of inner darkness, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, the video is just exploiting the fact that everyone, no matter what they look like, no matter who you are, has or could have some sort of, you know, dark side to you, or has something that, you know, is more than what they see on the outside.
It's your second year doing this tour. Last year it was Thrash and Burn. They just kind of changed the name around. How does this tour compare to doing smaller venues? Like, what do you prefer doing? Do you prefer doing like the five bands? Do you prefer doing this where you get a shorter set time and everything like that? Like, how's your input on?
It's definitely half and half. Like, the five band tours are, you know, you don't have to drive all through the night and, you know, fucking wake up at 8 o'clock in the morning and get your shit going. I like all day tours like that, just like this, just because there's so many bands and it brings so many different people. Like, there's not any one band on this tour that draws everyone. So you're being, you know, put out there to people that normally you wouldn't be able to get to see your band, or that wouldn't be able to see your band. So I like all day stuff like this where there's more bands, more fans.
So Creatures is pretty much like, what, a year old now, kind of?
It came out like mid-October last year.
Yeah, so it's almost a year old and you just released Creatures. You got any other plans for releases or anything like that in the works right now?
Yeah, we're doing a couple different videos like today, starting today, and for the next like 8 to 10 days we're filming a live video for our song Puppets. So that's going to come out. We're doing another video for another song on a record that I can't say anything yet. And it's going to be produced by someone who I kind of like, my mind is blown that they're going to be doing it. So that's two awesome things.
I won't put in the guess this time for it, because last time I ruined it. But
you know, you can, but I don't think you'll get it. After that, we do Europe. We do Fearless Friends tour, and then we're gonna start recording the next record after all that's done. So early next year we'll be recording.
It's pretty busy. You guys got a whole lot of videos lined up then, huh?
It's just a way that, you know, like, we're a very visual band. We're, you know, always, you know, that's what we try to thrive off of, is the fact that we have, you know, some sort of visual value to us. So we just like making videos to help prove or help get our point as a band across.
It's definitely better than just being a band that doesn't put out any sort of thing. Like, I know there are bands that just like don't put out any music videos, and everyone's just kind of like, where the hell are the music videos?
It's kind of like, we live in such a now generation where people want shit now and they do not want to wait for it, and it's gotten so bad where, you know, people don't even want to read shit. They want to hear it, and if they can't hear it, they want to see it. So it's like, if you don't have something to give to people after a very short spans of time, then they just lose interest. It doesn't matter who you are, they're just going to lose interest, because it's just the way our generation is, you know?
I sound like an old guy. Back in my day.
So there's been a whole lot of talk about, you know, what you said about Johnny Craig, and then that lashing back and forth, and then this thing with Blackfield Brides. Do you want to put any of these rumors to rest, say anything about them?
Please. As far as the Johnny Craig stuff goes, you know, I said what I said, he said what he said, and it's kind of over with now. You know, like, him and I came face to face at Warped Tour a bunch of times, and neither of us, you know, said anything. It's not like, you know, I pushed out or he was a pussy and didn't say anything to me. It's just, it's kind of like over and done with. It doesn't need to be fucking, exploded into anything else more than what it already was. you know, I'm not sorry that I said what I said. I wish I worded it better on the spot. Yeah. It's like I said, it's fucking over with, and
yeah.
I don't care anymore. And if he does, then whatever. It seems like more of his fans are pissed at me than he is.
Yeah.
Whatever. Don't care.
Yeah.
As far as the Black Girl Brides thing, that shit like started and happened and just evolved into this monster that became.
What exactly happened for people who don't know?
We went on tour with them in October last year, and the way that it all started, like, I'm not gonna, you know, fucking put this drama story on an interview. It's just
it's a short
story. There were some things that they said, or not they, but Andy had said about us on stage, just because. For whatever reason, you know, we kind of like were like, wow, that's, you know, unprofessional that he would say shit about our band on stage when we were nothing but super nice to those guys. The other dudes were awesome. We thought we were getting along with Andy, and he was, you know, cool everybody, but then he would say stuff that was clearly directed at us, and we never said anything back. We never backlashed. We never wanted to start drama or anything like that, because, you know, like, their fans are our fans. You know, we treat everybody with respect. So after that, a couple months later, that's when, like, you know, some people in our band made some comments that definitely got out there, and it just evolved, like I said, into this fucking monster that shouldn't have happened. And fortunately, on Warped Tour, the first day that we did on Warped Tour, we confronted each other, like, us and Andy, talked about it, squashed everything. It's like, anything that was a war is now fucking over with. Us and Black Girl Brides are friends. There's nothing going on. It's over with, and there never was anything serious to begin with. So, fans just like blowing shit out of proportion, I guess.
So we can expect to see a Black Girl Brides, Motionless in White, and then Dance Gavin Dance tour.
That would be awesome. I would love every
squash the beef tour.
Yeah. If this happens, you get full credit.
All right,
squash the beef tour. We need it.
All right, so now we'll move on to some fun questions. What's the biggest misconception about tour life?
That it's, you know, all glitz and glamour, and, you know, you make tons of money, and it's all that shit. Fortunately, I know, like, up until now, like, recently, you know, we used to tour in a van. Sleeping with seven dudes in a van fucking sucks. It's just a lot of shit that, like, as a band that's actually, you know, has in a position like we are, I can't even say anything that would sound like I'm bitching, because that would make me sound unfortunate, which I'm, you know, I'll fucking ride in a van and eat raviolis out of a can for the rest of my life if as long as, you know, we're able to do what we want to do. It's just hard. You're away from home. You have no shower. It's just, you know, like, everything that you're normally used to on your everyday life is taken from you, and then you're given in return. Getting to play to a bunch of kids, you know, like, getting your music out there, just everything that you really wanted to do. So, misconception is just the fact that everyone thinks that it's, like, super glamorous when it's not. But, you know, if you're in a band and in the position where we are, you have no fucking right to complain about it.
So. Yeah, yeah. So, does anyone else in the band have any other hobbies besides, you know, obviously making music? Like, do you guys do anything else, like, any other talents you guys have?
I actually spitfire. I'm just kidding.
How awesome would that be to add that to your live show? Dude, just, like, spitfire in the middle of it?
I'd probably burn the fucking building down. I'd get careless with that shit. Angelo designs all of our merch. Like, he does a lot of designs for, like, a ton of bands on Fearless. He does a lot of designs for, you know, if you walk into Hot Topic, probably at least five of the designs on the wall are done by Angelo. Ricky writes a lot. He, not like books, he just writes a lot of short stories and puts it on Tumblr, and, you know, kids read it and like it. Those are pretty much the only two that those guys do. I just try to my best to, like, keep up with fans, so it's not really a hobby or anything like that. It's just what I do on my off time.
So what do you think, if you weren't in a band, what do you think you'd be doing?
I don't know, man. If it wasn't for music or being in a band, I really don't think that I would be the person I am, at least. Fuck. I'd probably be dead, you know? Like, without music, really. I know it sounds so cliche to hear and say, you know, music really saved my life, but, you know, that's the fucking truth, and that's why we do what we do. To hear that we can do something like that for someone else is, you know, exactly what I got out of bands doing it for me, so, yeah.
All right, so last question. News on, zombies have started taking over the entire world. What is your strategy?
I would hide behind you because I'm a bitch. I'd be like... No, I wouldn't let them eat you. Fuck, I don't know. I guess I would just head for high ground, head for a fucking somewhere that seemed like it would be safe. I'd probably just go to a Walmart.
See, that's what I would do. Yeah. That's what I would do.
What doesn't Walmart have that isn't a zombie shelter?
Exactly.
I think that's why Walmarts were put on the earth, because the government knows that there's going to be a zombie outbreak and Walmarts will be the safe zone.
So, like always, anything you want to say to your fans? Anything you want to say before we get out of here?
Just thank you as usual, you know, like, I say it in so many times that I don't want it to get boring, but like, you know, as you guys know, you are the reason that we exist, and thank you so much for all the support. There's no more fucking war with the Black Veil Brides shit, so cut that shit off. Tell your friends that are Black Veil Brides fans that think that there's this big war, that there is not, because I'm so sick of hearing about it. And yeah, just thank you, thank you, thank you.
All right, thanks, man.